be relaunched, a terrifying 22 years post-publication. Yeah, really old, but quite frightening. It's just going to be lovely to see an aspect that we've been for a while. So we've covered subjects from that was commissioned by the Eden Project, about gardens, to a very technical body book, which had to be had to draw from life, so draw from pickled bits of bodies. And then more recently, I now write and illustrate my own books, which you may have seen pop up London around. Each book takes about a year to do, and they're very labour intensive. There's a lot of bloody windows in New York. That's sort of cursing all the tiny miniature drawings. Also, I've created a cookbook, which you're probably a different generation now, but when I had that little tiny baby is now nearly 16. So, and also patches, which you may have seen sitting around. They are from my drawings. So everything I do is drawn from reference. I don't really draw from my imagination or from life very often. It's all from looking up, thank gosh, the visible images, every illustrator sort of absolutely couldn't live without it. So if I wanted to kind of draw a blue tick, I would look at Google Images and then just copy it. So that's quite a key point of what I do in Sketchbook Club. So everything, all my drawings, everything, I use as reference, and that's really important. I think that actually drawing from life and drawing from your imagination is very difficult and very terrifying, actually. It's really a very scary thing. So I've always been a little bit obsessed with sketchbooks. I have millions, literally. And I now, because I'm a bit time starved, I tend to just create holiday diaries. I think it's really interesting that if you're an illustrator, you don't stop, you carry on going on holiday, and that's sort of a real sign of just how much pleasure drawing gives people. So the first holiday diary I did, I went to Barcelona for 3 months when I was 21 in exchange. And I did a page every single day. It's that orange book, it's really tatty, but all my diaries are there, but they're not personal. Well, they're not personal, but they were seen until Instagram. And Instagram was so fabulous for me as an illustrator. It's actually, it's quite an isolated profession. You're on your own, you're there with your colour pencils, your angle points, and no one else. And actually, I'm a bit an externaliser, and I'm not one of those people that, you know, you look at the sunsets, I don't really enjoy it unless I'm with someone else, you look, it's beautiful. And so I think it was a real, just wonderful to be able to create something and then share it and then engage with people. And it sort of gave me more of an incentive to kind of work in my sort of personal time as well. And actually, that you're creating with holiday diaries a real amazing document of memory book. It's something really special and sacred. I'm going to keep them forever. And actually, if you're like me, I get quite bored on holiday. I said to some recently, I don't know if I really enjoyed holiday before I had diaries. It's really awful. But there's something really lovely about having that on a busy evening with a glass of wine and just enjoying the day. So as I said, I will have my iPhone and a picture of a boat and I will draw from it. It's incredibly easy. And that's what I kind of want to share with people in Sketchbook Club, is just the methods that illustrators use, I think really anyone can use. So because I was sharing it on Instagram, there was this sort of general kind of push for how do you do that? I want to do it, I want to take part in that. So I put up a post about 3 years ago, I think, saying, okay, let's all do this, let's do this together. And I was really overwhelmed by how many people took part. It was so happy, and they were mimicking my diaries, which is, I'm not precious about my work, I think it's fantastic. Let's all do it together, and it was, it was really lovely. So because of that, there was then a sort of, well, I wonder if I could get this to work. I wonder if I could really share this whole, this is reference, this is a method. So I decided to do a bit of an experiment at my daughter's old school. They had a bit of a weak art department anyway, so I thought we'd quite nice to support them. And I started Sketchbook Club. So they were 11-year-olds, and I had about 30 of them. and I gave them reference and instructions and left them to it. And what was really amazing was that even the ones who didn't do art and thought they weren't good at art were creating really quite fabulous pieces of work, and the teachers were really surprised that they don't, he's not good at art, but that's quite good. And I think it was that giving them instructions and not telling them, draw that vase of flowers or draw that apple. It was that lovely freedom. And also same reference, same instructions, totally different work. It was wonderful. And I thought, well, this is I really, I'm honest with you here. So also, because of Instagram, there was a sort of general, what are you doing with the grown-ups? Doing with the grown-ups. So this is my studio in Hampshire. And I hold evening on every Tuesday, and I do all day Sketchbook Club, which are really great. I have a busy lunch and do about six spreads, it's fab. and I'm there, and I'm just kind of going through the spreads. There are some samples on the wall of what we've done in all days or in the evening. But then, again, because of Instagram, there were lots of people saying, oh, I live in Newcastle, I live in Canada, where can I come? And I thought, would it work online? So I started a sort of online sketchbook club, which we launched it just under a year ago, and it's been a success. It's me butchering onto camera, as if you've got me in person. And then there are printouts of reference. So this is my favourite. If you do just one, this is my favourite. It's in course two, and it's called Nature Table. But what's really lovely about the online is that I can do really close-up demos, which are really difficult to do in a big room, because I think you can see that that's a lovely technique where you scratch with a needle onto wet watercolour, and the watercolour kind of seeps into the scratches. So that's a lovely thing, actually, about the whole of the video. And then the fact that you are sort of presented at the end with everybody's work, and it's always everybody's very different, but they've had the same reference. So on the online course, this one, and we have the fish one, and we use something which I want to try and sort of demonstrate with you later, but where you can draw over, so with the fish, you can draw over the fish in a pencil, turn it over and roll on the back. Something like a fish sounds really simple, but if you draw it, you sometimes feel a bit childish. So there are these really simple techniques I use. So a lot of these that you see were using that as a transfer method. So it's not cheating, honest. It's just a really lovely way of creating images. So things like the sea, this is really interesting, because if people who've done this module say, that's great, it's when I do my diaries and my drawing. I used to do the sea, and it just used to look a bit like a kid's painting. But actually, you stylize it, and you've got something to copy or just inspire. I think that's the key thing, but that kind of fear is taken away. And then these people who are drawing my sketchbook club, who don't consider themselves to be able to draw, were creating these beautiful illustrations of water. And the lovely thing is, it's cross-generational. It's this work for adults and children. I love what the kids do. I love fantastic fish, and they look actually really sophisticated if you give them that bit of reference and you give them that little bit of help. And then the lovely thing is, they're all completely different. So I guess my firm belief is that we should be drawing and getting as much pleasure out of drawing as we do cooking, that we don't. No, it's very unusual, actually, for people to draw. And I think that's because deep in our psyche, we've told ourselves, or we believe, we can't draw. But I think that that's because we think of drawing as drawing from life. We think, well, I wouldn't be able to do that. I couldn't sit and draw that National Trust property, or I couldn't draw that vase of flowers. Or drawing from your imagination. Now, I'm never, ever faced with a blank page and think, oh, what should I do today? Ever. I have a brief, I have reference, I know exactly what I'm doing. And that, for me, that would be terrifying. I draw every day. The fear of that blank page is really strong, and I think it would really put me off if I just said, I've got to draw, I don't know, I'm trying to draw a tree, and I don't know what I'm doing. And then you kind of, that's it, you think, pushed away, I told you I couldn't draw. But actually, if you're given reference, like the waves and the fish, and you've got some examples in front of you, I mean, going back to that cooking analogy, it's a bit like a recipe. Why don't we follow for drawing. It works, it's perfect. You've got the method and instructions, and here's some pictures of the cake. And you wouldn't sit and play the piano without a sheet of music. Well, I don't really get it. I don't understand why we don't all do it. We're not treating it as a prescriptive action. At the end of the day, all you want to do is to end up with something that you're proud of, and that the whole process has been a huge pleasure. That's the whole point. It doesn't matter if you're copying or tracing. The lovely thing as well is that there's a whole community. When you've got a second, check out the hashtag Sketchbook Club Housing, which is the first module. First time I looked at it, I cried. It's so lovely. There are just so many people who have taken part and how they're all different. So all these are from Instagram. And again, they've had the same reference and they've had the same instructions, but they're all really different. And there's something really special about having started with a blank page, actually, because it's not a colouring book, it's yours. No one's done that. And I think that's really special when you've kind of created it yourself. I think pretty much all the ones I'm showing you on the wall, they're all using those methods, so you're all transferring Sketchbook Club. This is a really successful one because they couldn't have believed they'd done it, but it's that transfer method that we'll try out in a minute, where they've drawn and then they scribble in the back, so it's transferred, and then you're painting it. It's yours, you've created it. Drawings and methods are getting really lost in the whole concept, because that's what it's like for me, and that's what I thought other people to feel as lost in the process. It's that really special, meditative, slightly magic feeling when you get lost in the drawing. I use doodles a lot, and this is something I really want to share with you, because doodling, actually, when you try and get home, you're really creating a really special doodle, and you start it, and it's just not do it, it's not as good as the ones I see on Instagram. And actually, it's about copying, having something that's a little bit inspirational, and you might think, that's a really good sort of painted swirl, I like that flower. You've done it once, when you're next on a train with the doctors, I hope you might remember some of them, because then suddenly a plane journey becomes really pleasurable, because you can cover a whole surface with what these little tricks that you've remembered. And also just introducing people to some really gorgeous techniques like painting on black paper, which I'm quite obsessed with, there are a few around here, but it's so simple, but they're just jump out from the page, and people love it. And again, this is the transfer, so they have drawn over and rubbed over the back. I don't think it's cheating, because at the end of the day, as I said, it's about the process being really, really pleasurable and really proud. This is what we did last week. So we transferred the body, the people, and then the tails, they just went for it. And that, they couldn't go wrong, because they put the body, the peacock, which is really hard. And then they had these wonderful, creative, swirly tails, and they were all really thrilled with them. And just things like drawing on white pencil on paint. Every week I try and introduce a different tip. So the old days get for clubs, it's like having a dinner party, and things all prepared, so all the maps are cut out and the references are there. But at home with the modules, there are a few things you need to source, like old books, or we did have the old map around. But it's all about trying out maybe techniques you haven't used for a long time. This one we use splatter a toothbrush, which you probably haven't done since you were 8, but it's so fun. you just have to draw in the face and paint the background black and then go with a paintbrush, which is all you want to do. But those are definitely things that we've forgotten about, which are just so lovely to reintroduce into our lives. It's such a joyful thing. So, I'll shut up for a minute. So what you've got is some reference on your table, and there are three methods that I sort of want to try and introduce you